Hey, Chair. Whoa, easy now. Easy. What the hell happened to you? My God, look at your face. Did you get into an automobile accident or something, or fall down 20 flights of steps? Look at you. Okay, all right, okay. I'll accept partial responsibility for what happened. And on my part, perhaps I owe you an apology, and we need to discuss that, because I don't think you're in the right frame of mind to work tonight.
No, the hell I'm not. I came here to work. I'm ready to work.
Well, easy, no? I don't want you going out there with your head full of ill thoughts about me or about other people and saying the wrong thing. So before you go to work tonight, we need to have a little discussion in my office, if you don't mind. I just want to make sure that you're in the right frame of mind, if you understand. Hey, JR. I'll see you in my office, pal.
Now, you're comfortable, aren't you?
Yeah.
Pretty comfortable sofa. Now, I brought you here to get you in the right frame of mind, JR. You want a cup of coffee or, you know, something to drink, or, you know, you sure?
Fine.
Well, I mean, I have to be certain, you see, because I want nothing but the very best for WWF fans. I want you to go out there with a clear conscience and work as you normally do. So to get you in the right frame of mind, I've invited somebody to join us.
Mind if I join you, do you? Well, pal. You don't mind, do you?
Do you mind?
That pretty little cowboy hat you got on, son.
Now, just calm down, JR. This isn't exactly what it looks like. No, you see, we're here to entertain you. And in a few minutes, we're gonna show some movies. JR, I apologize because we don't have any popcorn for you. No soda. You didn't want any soda, okay? So, I mean, just for this special movie. And look at the name of this movie. The Life and Times of Good Old JR, okay? Now then, what we have here is, well, we have SmackDown last Thursday. Oh, look at this.
There's a lot of things I'd like to talk to you about in private that hadn't been made possible. This is not about me and you. I just think there's a lot of questions, Steve, that you should answer for the fans around the world. And the first question, I think, is the most obvious one, is that why in God's name have you aligned yourself with Mr. McMahon, a human being that I know in your heart you have despised more than anybody walking the face of the earth?
Well, that's a pretty simple answer. It's an insurance policy, Jim. How stupid are you? I'm Stone Cold Steve Austin.
Now then, what do you think of her film? Was that a double thumbs up or what, JR?
Don't eyeball me. Don't you dare eyeball me, you son of a bitch. You and I watch that tape back, and you know what it makes me realize? It makes very clear to me how weak and how pathetic you are. Don't ever look at me. I ain't got nothing else to say to you.
So now, are you in the right frame of mind to go to work tonight, JR?
Oh, yeah.
Good.
Oh, yeah.
Good.
I've also talked to my attorney. And he tells me I got hell of a lawsuit here if I choose to go that way. But that's never been my style. So, my other options, I guess, I could just quit tonight.
Oh, yeah. You know, you're the quitting kind, aren't you? Is that what you want to do? You want to quit?
And if I quit tonight, Vince, I'm going to work tomorrow for your son, Shane, down in WCW. So if you'll excuse me, I got a job to do. I'm going to work.
You better damn well do it, too.